Hi everyone, this is Dr. Derek Ong. In this video, I'm going to talk to you and discuss with you about perceptual mapping, kind of like brand image profiling using correspondent analysis as a part of the series of marketing analytics videos that I produce. So let's begin by defining what the objective of brand image profiling is. Now, brand image profiling is basically trying to measure consumers' perceptions of brands through an association, association with relevant attributes. And usually these attributes are measured and it's using quantitative studies where the respondents are asked to rate brands on a set of attributes. And it could be a quality, it could be premium, it could be anything that you might want to associate that brand with. And these are measured on a 5, sometimes 7, or even a 10-point Likert scale, ranging from disagree to agree or satisfied or unsatisfied. So it depends on how you label the Likert scale. All right, so before I get to the example, I just want to show you what is correspondent analysis and how a perceptual map looks like when you use correspondence analysis. Okay, so if you look at this particular map here, it shows a two-dimensional perceptual map. It can be more than two dimensions, but for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to stick to two dimensions so that it's not too confusing. So the perceptual map is a depiction of entities that reflect similarity and differences between the entities. The further the entities are away from each other shows a disparity, but the closer the entities are to each other shows the perceived similarities. So this means that the lines here shows how far a particular attribute, yeah, that is further away from the origin of the dimension, shows the great importance of that attribute in differentiating offerings in the market. So for example, in this particular example, if you want to be a really, really good shampoo in the market, one of the best ways to differentiate yourself is to have a strong perceived hair expert attribute, and you can really, really become a strong brand of shampoo in the market and differentiate yourself from the rest of other brands. Okay, now the other thing I want to show you is and you want to access the strength of a brand's position of any attribute, right? Let's say, for example, like the strength of the brand of let's say Vidal Sassoon, for example, against, let's say, Hair Expert. So what you need to do is to draw, and just imagine if you draw an imaginary line of the imaginary perpendicular line, sorry, perpendicular means drawing, sorry, let me just clear this up. So you draw a perpendicular line from the brand to the line, right, to the attribute. So the further an offering is from the origin along the direction of the attribute, right? That means along the direction of the attribute, that means here, then the higher is the rating of the offering on that attribute. So for example, if let's say like this, okay? You notice that Vidal Sassoon is very far away from, let's say compare it with Elseve, along the line of Hair Expert. Now, it is not really far away from Hair Expert, but it is also very far away from the origin. So what this means that Vidal Sassoon is very closely related to becoming a Hair Expert, and that's how people perceive Vidal Sassoon to be as a Hair Expert. All right, so I'm going to be showing you a demonstration in SPSS on how to do correspondence analysis using the data set that we're going to see in the next slide. Now, before I go into the data set, let me explain to you a bit of a context of what we're looking at. So the context that we're looking at here today is doing a rating on coffee brands using statements using scale of 1 to 5, where of course 1 equals to strongly disagree and then 5 equals to strongly agree. So keeping the brand in mind, each of the brands have to be answered on this set of attributes. So for example, if let's say the first brand is AAA, then we say AAA is seen as manly brand, AAA is seen as fattening, AAA is perceived as premium brand, and they will have to answer this along the 5-scale rating. Then they have to do that again for another brand, the same attributes, and another brand for the same attributes, and so on and so forth until they finish. So the data set that you see here has only 3, columns, which I have actually did some already analysis to it. So for example, the first column will have images, 23 attributes. So each of these 23 attributes along each of the brands. So it kind of like links the brand and the attribute together. There are 23 attributes altogether, and each of the 23 attributes are put along the brand. And then what you see is that there are 6 brands, AA and FF. So you will notice that there will be 23 times 6 rows of questions that are combinations of attributes and brands together. Right. And then the frequency will show you the frequency of agreeability. Now, because there are 5-point Likert scale here, so what I've decided is I just want to look at the agreeability strongly agreeability factors, which means that as long as they put a 4 and a 5 along the brand to the particular image, then it was counted as a 1. So this means that, for example, if I look at the top here, this means that brand AA is perceived as fattening by 82 people in the respondents list. Okay, so strongly agreed. Statement AAA is fattening. All right. Okay, so first thing you need to do is because we are looking at frequencies of agreeability, we need to first weight the cases first. So what we need to do is go to data, select weight cases. You got to weight the cases by the number of frequency. So because they are all different in terms of its frequency, so it's best that we weight the cases by the frequency, and that will give us a much better analysis. And this is very important that we do this because the data set is done in such a way. All right. So then the cases are weighted. Now we can do our correspondence analysis. So we go to analyze, dimension reduction, we go to correspondence analysis. Image goes to the row, brand goes to the column. Make sure you define the range for the image. As we said that there are 23 attributes, so 1 to 23. So update that. And then for the range, for the brands, there were 6 brands, so make sure that we put in 6 brands inside, so update that. And then we continue. Under the model, we can just keep the chi-square. Dimension solution, we want 2 dimensions as we mentioned. Now make sure our normalization method here is symmetrical, because we want to make sure that it's symmetrical normalization. Statistics, we want to look at row points, column points as well. For plots, now this is the important one. We want to look at both the row plots, that means we're just looking at the brands, and then the column, the row plots as in the attributes, and then the column plots for the brands. And we also want to look at how the two stack up together in terms of the by plot. So that's why we look at the two. So press OK. Now, once we're done with that, I'm going to just go back and show you the results that we have. Okay? Okay, so very quickly remember that the cases need to be weighted by the frequency. Correspondent analysis, you go to analyze dimension reduction to correspondent analysis. Make sure you put in the row and put in the image of the number of images or the number of attributes that you're using. And then the brands, define the range. So same thing also, define how many ranges that you have. All right. Also for the models and plots, make sure you have your biplots as well, rows and columns. But you don't actually need the line plot because they actually don't really tell you much. But make sure you keep the chi-square for the correspondence analysis model. Right. So let me explain to you a little bit about the result that you get. So let's start with the row points for image. So you notice that the row points here, you have symmetrical normalization. Now, let's look at fresh and ugly. Right down here, fresh and ugly. Okay, so fresh and ugly are very closely related together. If you were to draw an imaginary line, they do seem to be somewhat in the middle, in the average profile. So indicating that fresh and ugly don't actually are not actually that far off in terms of their differences, right? And they are not that close to the origin. And you notice that they are very close to the origin, because if you look at this, the origin here is right here at the zero point, right? Sorry, drawing's a bit off. So they are very close to the origin. So you notice that fresh and ugly are very close to the origin, indicating that they differ little from an average row profile. Okay, now the next thing I want you to see would be the three general classifications emerge. So I'm going to show you the three general classifications. So the first classification you see is tough, men, and working. Now, notice right up here, tough, men, and working, they are very similar to each other. Sorry. And then the next one you'll see will be sweet, fattening, and children. Sweet, fattening, and children. And premium as well, right down here. And then you see another one in contrast, healthy, low fat, and nutritious. Maybe I used a different color. Right here. Healthy, low fat, and nutritious, right down here. Whoops, sorry. Just click this one off. Healthy. Oof. Right here. So there are three very distinct classifications on the cluster. So you notice that this classification shows that these are the attributes that people indicate to be quite similar to each other. And in terms of their attribute dimensions, yeah, for and in terms of the image. Okay, then the next one we want to look at is the column points for the brand. Now notice that the column points for the brand, that all the brands are quite far from the origin. Again, if you want, I can show you the origin. Goes up and here. Well, except for, yeah, so they are all quite far from the origin. So no brand is similar to the overall centroid, right? Yeah, so you notice that brand CC and DD are grouped together. Brand CC and DD are grouped together, whereas brand BB and FF, they are clustered in the lower half of the plot. And as well as AA and EE are not similar at all to each other. So which means they are really, really not similar to each other brand. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm also going to show you the next thing on how to plot these lines that you want to see here. Okay, so before I move on to the final part, I just want to show you how to set in the origin line at the 0, 0 point so that you don't get confused on where and how the origin line is, because it looks as if the origin line is here, but if you look at the scale here, it's not actually the origin line. So all you need to do is go to your output, double click on your graph, and you notice this thing here, adding reference line to the axis. Now, it is automatically set at the midpoint. So make sure you change this position to 0 and apply. And the same thing for this one. You just have to set in the reference line at the y-axis. Again, make sure you change this to 0. Okay? And apply. Then you can see where the origin lines are. Okay, if you want, you can also do the same. Let me just show you that to you again, right? Double click, make sure you choose this, make sure you don't set it at the midpoint, but at the origin. And then also for this, make sure you show it at the 0. Right, got it? And you do the same for the by plot as well, which I will show you the by plot later on. Yeah, and one thing about good by plot is that you don't have to change anything because it's already set at 0, so it's easy for you to look at it. Okay, all right, so that's how you do that. So I'm gonna go to the by plot right now and show you. Okay, so this is the final plot called when you put the brands and the attributes together onto one particular point. It's called a biplot. On the upper left, if you look at the resulting biplot, you notice that EE here is very much associated with the tough, manly, and the working group. So it shows that EE is a brand that appeals to working men. Okay, the coffee that is appealed to working men. Then you can also see that brand AA, which is right here, brand AA, is the most popular and also viewed as the most highly caffeinated, sweet fat, highly caffeinated, because you can see it's really right here. The reason why it is most popular because AA is very close to the origin. It's the closest to the origin. So if you notice that any brands that's close to the origin means that a lot of people like it. But the further away it is from the origin means that not so many people like it, and it's a select few people, or your segmentation target is very, very small. Okay, that's what it is. Then the sweet and fattening brands, which is BB and the FF, these are somewhere around the dimension here, okay? And then finally, you have the brands CC and DD, which is low fat. If you notice, fattening and low fat is far away from each other, are also the most unpopular. So the further the brand away from the origin, remember, that means that the brand is unpopular. So that's how you do a correspondence analysis. Now, I hope that you found this video tutorial very useful, because for marketeers, having a good correspondence analysis will really, really show you how you stack up, or brands, how brands stack up to each other, especially with attributes. And you can actually look at who are your closest competitors and how well or how niche your brand can be in terms of standing out from the other brands. All right, so please check out my other videos and subscribe when you can. So thank you very much.